said, it puts a smile on your face as we open our worship service here this morning. And we are glad you are here. And we'd like to, you to register your attendance so that we have record that you're here. So if you wouldn't mind doing that, the registration pads in the pews, we encourage you to sign those and pass them along. Just an announcement or two I want to lift up for you, not this week, but next week, we have our administrative meetings, trustees, finance, church council, some other things happening. Staff parish meets tomorrow, I believe it is. So those announcements are listed in your bulletin. I want you to be aware of those things. Chat and Chew, as it comes up in the month of October, is in your bulletin as well. So you have that date and time. Also, there's a message in there about sanctuary choir. We're going to have an organizational meeting. We take that term loosely, choir, but we're going to have an organizational meeting immediately after the service today. So just make your way up to the choir loft. We'll talk a little bit and figure out how we're going to function. It shouldn't be a prolonged period of time. It should be fairly short. So we invite you to come if you're interested to learn a little bit more about how we can sing together and praise the Lord. As we are in his house and as we've gathered to worship in his name, let's invite his presence to be among us. I would invite you to bow with me for a word of prayer. Lord God, there's so much happening in our world. It can be at times hard to unplug from all that and just settle and be still before the Lord. So Lord, help us in this hour to unplug from whatever it is, whatever our stresses are, whatever's bogging us down. Help us to unplug from that and plug into the power of Jesus Christ through his Holy Spirit. I pray, Lord, that you might be present in this place to touch hearts and lives. And we pray this in the mighty name of our Savior. Amen.
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 I'm going to invite you to stand with me as we sing our next song. It's God So Loved. I've done this for you a time or two. This is the first time we've done it all together. But I want you to join me. So let's stand together.
Bring up the water, come and thirst.
from Scripture as part of our Scripture reading this morning from John chapter 3. It says, as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. And this is God's word. We're ever so thankful for it. And as we sing this next song, we are coming to the end of our unit that we've been doing from 1 John, and we've talked a lot about love. And this is just an opportunity to sort of think back over that series and the love of God. And that's what this song encourages us to do, to think about his love.